We are looking into possibly claiming on insurance. Tim's looking at getting a builder in to look at things and that kind of thing. I did want to say shout out to Terry for fixing an ongoing leaky tap issue. It's fixed. Things are dried up. And the pipers are very thankful. what's next? There are a couple of reports that came through, Vickers report, the assistance report, the evangelism committee report, treasurer's report. I do want to just touch on a few things with that. As you know, we are having just ongoing financial issues. One of the main bits of feedback that we got from Jasmine actually was that with our last budget, there was a bit of a disconnect about understanding when we set a budget that we actually need to fund that budget. It's up to us to make sure that that budget is met. We can't just say, that sounds great, let's do it. So that's just something that came up and something that will probably be addressed a little bit better coming up to the next AGM. We did want to note though that there has been a jump in the last month or so from approximately 1,100 to 1,500. Is that extra giving? Weekly giving. So that's a really good positive step forward, and we still need to keep going up though. We're not quite there yet. There was a bit of a discussion about applying for funding for some ESL classes that Helen has been running. She gave us a bit of a rundown on what she's doing in teaching English as a second language with her little group, which was really interesting and funny, and we actually could see how valuable a ministry that is in our community. Not just as part of our church. They do read through the Bible to practice reading English, which we thought was great. We're thinking about ideas or ways that we could raise the awareness of our presence in our community. Things like advertising for weddings and even like the idea of a pop-up shop down the main street for running a kids program, just being more present in the community, being more visible. Good news, exciting news. We are planning, we are in the planning, it has commenced for a parish camp next year. So keep your ears open. If you have any questions, come and see me or Judy. We haven't met yet, but we'd love to talk to you. We need ideas as well, so come and talk to us. We're looking at ideas of improving or clarity of the signage around the church. Also, something that was raised was we actually have a lot of different people from different nationalities coming and visiting our church from time to time. And we actually don't have any Bibles here in their languages. And that was a bit of a problem that we saw, because we wanted them to be able to see God's word and read it. We didn't actually come to a definitive course of action. At the moment, we're just probably going to try and encourage them to find it on their phones in their language, and that way they can take it home as well, and it's there with them as well. And we have some pregnant cattle. So we have got a bit of a cattle initiative going. Some cows at the Chaffees are to be pregnant tested soon. And the Carters also have some cows that are preggers. So that's nice. And that was about it. You probably, come and see Simon if you want to know anything else. Thanks.
Thank you, Lisa. That's a report up on our cattle fund, which is a great initiative that's working quite well. Okay, when you came in, you would have had an opportunity to get an InTouch, a yellow sheet, I believe it is. So we might just run through a few of those items. We're just going to play a quick video on Hope Explored and some information on that. It's the 8th, the 15th and the 22nd of June, 6:30 dinner for 7:30 p.m. at Alex and Jen's place. So we might play the video.
There are few emotions more powerful than hope. It's a spark inside you that brings a smile to your lips, a light that shows on your face, a feeling that lifts your head and pulls you forward. These days, hope like that often feels hard to come by. Maybe you've experienced your share of disappointments, but real hope is what the Christian faith claims to offer. A joyful expectation for the future, based on true events in the past, which changes everything about my present. Hope Explored is a 3-session series for anyone who is looking for a hope worth having. Whatever you do or don't believe, this is your invitation to explore, to discuss, to question, to discover. This is Hope Explored.
So for those that are interested, I believe there are some of these postcards up the back, and it's got that information, 105 Hunter Street. And thank you, big thank you to Alex and Jen for hosting. Next is a reminder of the men's dinner. Also, I believe, yes, there are postcards. So an opportunity, I think, today, Pete, as the men's ministry team have put a lot of effort into this dinner that's on this Wednesday. If you have not yet signed up, you can pay on the day, or you can go online through our app and you can also pay. But we are looking for more numbers. It's a good roll-up so far, but there's plenty more room. As I said, a lot of effort has been put in to coordinate this men's dinner, not only for us in our congregation or within the parish, but also for those people we know that we should just ask. Those people who are close to us that we want to be able to share God's word, then please take one of these. All they can say is no, men. If you ask someone, don't be frightened. The worst they can do is say no, but they might just say, geez, I'm glad you gave me this. I'd love to come along. Please do that. We would like to, I think, Peter, today is the last day. We do need numbers for catering. Monday, the absolute latest. I think actually it says on there closed on Friday, but I'm sure if there are more numbers, we'd love to have them. Next, Working Bee. We all remember that we all had our name signed down to do some amazing things, and then it got rained out, and we thought we all got away with it and we didn't have to do anything. Well, not the case. It's back on. Coming up in 2 Saturdays' time, May 25th, there is a fresh sheet up the back for you to put your name down to one of those tasks that have already been planned out. But if you know another task that needs to be done around our church, then please write that on the list too, especially if it's one that you want to do, not just suggest that somebody else does. If you can't come, you can't be part of it for some reason, we all live busy lives, so understand that, but you've got time at another time and you'd like to take on one of those jobs, then please see Simon or David and let them know, because you might need a key or you might be able to need access, or you just need to understand if there's something else going on in or around the church in the time that you might have picked. But please, if you've got some time and some skills, or even no skills but plenty of energy, and you want to participate, let us know. Long service leave. Now, I think in your little yellow sheets, it might say in there that Simon has been working for 0 years within the... That's what it says in there. But it's actually wrong. It's 30 years, so it's now time for long service leave. Simon, Jenny and Alex will be on long service leave through the months of August, September and October. And I know we all wish them well in their time away, well-earned time, serving not only here in Gunnedah, but right throughout the diocese and making a difference in so many people's lives. So we certainly all wish them very well. There's plenty of planning between now and August, and I'm sure that you'll be encouraging for both Jenny and Simon to make sure that they focused, because they're not going till August and there's still plenty to do until then. Now, in saying that, the next note is about the AGM. So normally we wouldn't have our AGM before August, but because Simon and Jenny and Alex are going away on long service leave and we really need Simon to be here, for the AGM, that we're moving that forward. So Parish Council, that's another decision Parish Council have made, is we're going to pull it forward a few weeks, and it will be on Sunday the 23rd of July. So put that in your calendars, on your phone, write it on your hand, put it on your fridge, wherever. But remember to please come along and be part of the AGM. For those who are interested in serving on Parish Council, we'd love to see your name. Put your hand up to be one of those people that continue to serve to make sure that we have a strong church. For those also who are in different ministries and you would normally prepare a report that I believe will be tabled at least, but potentially might have an opportunity to speak to at the AGM, then now's the time to start finding a quiet spot with a cup of tea and start putting your report together on those different ministries, because I haven't actually got a date here, but I'm sure that will be maybe the latest will probably be early July, but it could be late June. Looking at Simon, but he's not telling me, so I guess the best thing to do is start being prepared for your report. Okay, I think that is the end of notices, unless there's another slide, Terry. No, that's the end of notices. So I'd encourage you to take that yellow sheet home with you, keep it somewhere close. So if you're not sure about some of those dates or things that are coming up, you'll have that access to that sheet. But also, for those of you who do have the app, how good is the app? It's fantastic. It's even much better than a notice. For those who don't have an app but you'd like to have that app, if you've got a phone, reach out to someone who's 20 or younger, and I'm sure that they'll give you 5 minutes and download that app for you on the phone and show you how to use it, because I think it's absolutely brilliant. We've all got our phones with us all the time, and it's really quick and easy to get on and see who's on, depending on what service or what's coming up within our church. So this is our last song. We please all stand and join in with big voices for The Power of the Cross. we need to be alert every minute of every day. How good is it that we have a forgiving God, but we need to repent. If in something that's come across in today's sermon is particularly an issue for you and you'd love to talk to someone about that or someone to pray with you, then I encourage you to reach out to Simon this morning. He would love to see you. To our music team and to the sound people and everyone else who served today, to serve your church for today's sermon, I'll say thank you. Please stay with us for morning tea.